Well, first of all, we have an external CSS file which we need to construct the CSS on. So if I inline that, then that could save a lot of time. Same goes for JavaScript. If I inline that, then we can skip the request. And in fact, if I inline both, then that's even better because my critical path length will be one. As soon as I have the HTML file, I have everything I need.
Yep, that's right. Those are definitely good strategies. Just be careful when you apply them. Remember that inlining a lot of JavaScript and CSS, especially when those resources can be used between multiple pages, can lead to a lot of overhead.
Right. Good point. All right, speaking of which, I guess I don't know if this applies to this exact case, but if I knew what was inside the CSS and JavaScript files, then I could also consider adding a media type to the CSS or making the script async.
Yep, you got it. Just to confirm though, what would you look for in these CSS and JavaScript files?
Well, for CSS, I'd want to make sure the styles are actually required to render the page. If they're not being used, I could add an appropriate media type attribute and unblock rendering. Also, it's pretty much the same idea for JavaScript. If the script is not manipulating or accessing the DOM or CSS OM, then I could add an async attribute, which would unblock DOM construction.
Yep, that's awesome.